Hello everyone and welcome back guys to round 17 of season 3 of the F1 2019 Haas Road to Glory career mode, where today we're here back for one of the most famous tracks on the Formula 1 calendar, the only figure eight circuit in the world of F1. We're here today ready for the Japanese Grand Prix, 5 rounds to go of season 3 of the F1 2019 Haas Road to Glory, and hopefully I've recorded a couple of extra races from this series. We're going to try and get it out over the next couple of weeks and obviously focus, get ourselves prepared and ready for season 4. Hopefully, well, no matter what happens, it will be our final season here of the F1 2019 Haas Road to Glory. I'm really, really hoping we can finish it with a world championship, but obviously we'll have to wait and see. Only time will tell. But obviously, if you guys are new around here as well, do get yourself subscribed for more F1 2019 content on the channel. I've got a bit more planned on this game, especially with the lack of IRL Formula 1 stuff going on at the moment. You definitely want to be in the YouTube space over the next couple of weeks. But yeah, jumping on though into this race weekend, Japan, it's a track that I do struggle with on F1 2019. It's a track that is renowned for the AI being very, very strong at as well. So it's going to be a tough testing Grand Prix ahead of us, 27 laps around this Grand Prix circuit at the end of the day. But Verstappen, he is looking in unstoppable form at the moment. Whether we're going to see that continue on into this race, only time will tell. And talking of the Red Bulls, Gasly actually this time out on pole position ahead of Verstappen, the championship leader. Hülkenberg in third ahead of Devon Butler, Hamilton, Weber, Vettel, Leclerc, and the Williams of Perez and Norris round out the top 10 there. Then we've got both McLarens, the Toro Rosso of Albon, myself, Raikkonen, Bottas, who's going to be very, very quick, starting 16th ahead of Giovinazzi, Kvyat, Ricciardo, and my teammate Romain Grosjean, both with penalties at the rear of the field there. So it's going to be an interesting race ahead of us, a couple of mixed up positions on the grid, but let's do this thing. We're ready here for the Japanese Grand Prix. Should be a fairly textbook one-stop strategy here today as well. Softs to mediums, it's not the most tire-intensive circuit at the end of the day, but you can find yourself hanging on a bit through the corners when the tires start to get quite worn as well around this racetrack. You can see, just confirming with the team that we're going to pit roughly the end of lap 11 here. We're going to try and give it just under 2 laps of spare fuel as well. Not the easiest track to burn the fuel at. But we're ready then on the grid for the Japanese Grand Prix. The 5 lights are on and it is going to be lights out and away we go. They're responding fairly poorly to the lights. We've got Raikkonen on the outside, who's going to get much better high-end traction there down in towards turn 1. So instantly we're going to slot back down in to pin 15 there. Try to have a look back at the inside of the finished driver through turn 1 and turn 2 there, but not able to make it work as we head through the S's first time round. Obviously so easy to make a mistake, get tangled up with another car here. Don't quite want to dip the wheels on the curbs. They are very, very lethal with the way I set up this car. It was running loose, I think it's safe to say, as you can already see, struggling to try and get the temperature down in the rear wheels there as we head through the Degnas for the first time in this Grand Prix. Everyone just bunching up through the second Degna there. You can see almost around to the back, actually. I think there was a tiny bit of contact with Kimi Raikkonen there. Going full send up the inside in towards the hairpin there, trying to take back our place from the start of the Grand Prix there. Get the power down nice and tidily off the exit of the hairpin there and just squeeze Raikkonen out as the track thins back up there. And yeah, back up straight away into P14 of the Grand Prix there. So towards the end of that one, we haven't lost a place in this race there, which still, despite the AI nerf, is quite an achievement on F1 2019 nonetheless there. But coming towards the end of lap 2, you can see already Max Verstappen and Pierre Gasly starting to run away in this racer at the front of the field. But we were trying to hang on with Alexander Albon at the moment. You can see Bottas just behind us now. Safety car has been deployed there. What's gone on? There's a car in the wall down at turn 1 there. That's Lucas Weber. He's out of the Japanese Grand Prix there. And let's have a look. You see he goes up the inside of one of the Mercedes. I'm guessing that's Butler. And the two GP2 rivals, a big, big crash as we head down in towards turn 1 there. It looks like suspension failure from the contact there. Very, very rarely do you see cars actually, you know, get damage from, obviously, contact with each other, wheel-to-wheel contact on F1 2019. But Devon Butler, I mean, we saw back in the past, Lucas Weber would complain about him going for aggressive moves, doing dangerous things on the circuit. I'm sure he's not very happy with him that time round there. Completely swiped across the front of the Ferrari down in towards turn 1 here. But by the end of the safety car period, though, we were ready to go once again. The field right back bunched up. You can see trying to look around the outside of Albon as we head down in towards the final couple of corners here. We're going to slot back in just behind him here, and unfortunately not actually responding too well to when the pack does go again there. It really didn't time itself nicely for myself. A lot of wheel spin out of the final corner here, and already we're not on the attack of Alexander Albon in front. We're actually on the defensive from Valtteri Bottas just behind us as we head down in towards turn one here. The Ferrari tries to have a look up the inside there. We try not to make the mistake that Devin Butler made and just about giving the room there. But through turn two, wheel to wheel contact between myself and Bottas. I've had to hang him out to dry through turn two there. We couldn't allow him to try and make the move work there around the outside through turn two. But I quickly realised in this race as we head through the exit of the S section here, you know, there's nothing we can really do in the long run to defend from Valtteri Bottas here. Albon already a 1.7 second margin just up the road here. As we head towards the end of lap six, starting to get the tyres back up to temperature as we head out of the final corner there. The gap to Albon just back down to 1.6, but yeah, Bottas behind us. He was a rocket ship as we head down towards turn one. Despite the lack of DRS, he tries to have a look around the outside. We actually run ourselves deep through turn one there, and Bottas, yeah, he's going to be able to get the switchback move and now move himself up into P13 of the Grand Prix. So we got past one retired Ferrari just to get jumped by the other not long later in this Grand Prix here. So Bottas at the moment then back up into P13, and we were still spending a lot more time looking at our mirrors than trying to look out in front in this race, which is really not what we needed at the moment there. As you can see, end of lap 9, Albon now 3.5 seconds up the road here, and Raikkonen was on the prowl once again, down in towards someone there. He tries to have a look up the inside, a bit of wheel-to-wheel contact once again between myself and the Alfa Romeo man there. Sergio Perez out of the Grand Prix as well on the inside of turn one there. I'm guessing that looked like an engine failure on the replay cameras there, just the way he was sort of parked up on the side of the road there. So it's all kicking off inside the opening 10 laps of this Japanese Grand Prix there. We are now up into P13 of the race once again. And actually, over the next couple of laps, we'll be trying to apply the pressure to Devin Butler here as the the pit window, even, I should say, had started to open up in this Grand Prix there. I think that was Hamilton and Sainz both being some of the earliest drivers to make the call here. And it wouldn't be long before we were all over the back of Devin Butler. I'm guessing he picked up some damage from that battle with Lucas Weber in the early stages of the race there. So up the inside as we head through Spoon Curve there. Now up into P10 of this Japanese Grand Prix here. And ideally at the moment, I'm trying to just pick up points where I can. If we can get a few top 10 finishes, I will certainly take that at the end of the day. But I just think, you know, at the moment, we're normally hanging on if we can try and score top 10s in these Grand Prix. Out of the final couple of corners though, Hamilton now trying to apply the pressure as we head down towards turn one here. A few more drivers now diving into the pit lane as well. We're going to be up into P6 momentarily there. We're going to drop back down. Leclerc exiting the pit lane as well. So we're actually going to end up in a bit of a Renault sandwich as we head through turn one there. Hamilton gets past us, we get past Leclerc, and now we're up into P5 of the Grand Prix, trying to take these softs just a little bit longer than everyone else and hope that we got a bit of an advantage as we head into the second half of this Grand Prix. Through the final corner, down towards the pit lane line there. Get it slowed down nice and tidily as we head into the pit lane there. And yeah, pretty much what we did, take those soft tyres halfway through this Grand Prix. So the mediums, they should be in quite good stead right the way through to the end. Obviously, we did have that safety car window for a couple of laps here. But yeah, hopefully these tyres should be able to last right the way through to the end of the Grand Prix here. You can see coming back out now, down into P12 here. We're going to be close with Ricciardo as we head down towards turn one there. But the Australian, he does swoop around the outside, and he now moves himself back up into P12 of the Grand Prix here. So at the moment, not quite inside the points, but not too far away either. You know, if we get another safety car in this race, we get a little bit of chaos there. A couple more retirements up the road. Japan, it is a bit of a weird track. You know, the AI can make mistakes and actually give themselves quite a few issues around this circuit. So perhaps we'll see that as well in the late stages of this race. But you can see we were still trying to apply the pressure to Daniel Ricciardo. He was on a set of the hard compound tyres here, so we were really, really trying to push there. You can see trying to fight the back end as we head through Spoon there. Now with the ERS and the Rich Revs trying to line up a move on the Mercedes as we head down in towards 130R. They're just about to get the nose up the inside. They're completely pinned. Full confidence in Ricciardo not to try and turn in there. And we now move ourselves back up into P12 of this Japanese Grand Prix here. So having to go for bullseye moves at the moment. And now, once again, we were trying to look to be in the hunt of Alexander Albon here. The gap now down to 2.8 seconds, and slowly but surely, over the next couple of laps there, sat in our fastest lap of the Grand Prix, that gap was really, really starting to come down at the moment. 8 tenths taken out of him on that lap alone there. And over the next couple of laps, you can see, end of lap 16, the gap was now down to 1.6 there, so another 3 tenths out of him on that lap. And yeah, we were just pushing like crazy at the moment, hoping we could try and take out this gap to Alexander Albon up the road there. But actually, Ricciardo, those hard tyres starting to come back into their own as we head into the final 10 laps of the Grand Prix there. He managed to get himself back inside the DRS window here and was really, really just hanging along with me at the moment. At the final corner, the end of lap 18, they're getting a little bit of wheel spin over the bump there. And now Ricciardo, he might be able to try and line up a move on us as we head down towards the turn one there. Another 4 tenths out of Alexander Albon though on that lap. And actually by lap 21, Ricciardo was hanging on in there, but we were really now getting up close to Alexander Albon here, out of spoon, using the ERS modes, everything like that, the rich revs, the Toro Rosso actually running very, very well around this circuit here. We thought about having a look up the inside, but just quite didn't have the run to have a look up the inside of the Toro Rosso there. Thought about going for it around the outside in towards the Casio Triangle there, but we've seen Alexander Albon in real life go for the dive bombs through there, so definitely don't want to try that on him. A huge, huge tank slapper out of the final corner there. We just about keep it pointing in the right direction, but with the DRS, look at the overspeed we've got in Albon as we head down towards turn one. We need a good traction run out of the final corner there to really be able to go for anything as we head through the first couple of corners here. If we can't make the move up before that, we can see out of spoon once again here, using the rich revs, using the ERS, everything like that. Can we get the run down in towards 130R this time around? We're a bit closer this time. We're going to have a look up the inside. We're wheel to wheel. And yes, we do now make the move work. And we are now up into P11 of the Grand Prix here. So right on the cusp of the points here. We just need one more retirement, one more issue in this Grand Prix. But a huge, huge train starting to form just behind us there. A couple of big snaps of oversteer out of the final corner as well. They're down towards someone. Albany's got the DRS now on us. Is he going to be able to have a look around the outside there? He tries to make the move work. We just keep the nose in. Albon runs himself wide, locks up. And we just about now hold on to P11 of the Grand Prix. 4 laps to go here of this Japanese race. You can see now Sergio Perez was actually the man applying the pressure here. We haven't seen much of Perez in this Grand Prix, but he was behind us in a bit of a quicker Williams car. Surely he's going to be able to have a look around the outside as we head down towards 130R there. He's got the overspeed on, struggling a bit towards the top end. We give him a bit of a squeeze, and we just about hold on this time round and live to fight another day in this race here. 3 laps to go now of the Japanese Grand Prix. We need someone retire up the road here if we want to try and take home points in this race there. Perez now, though, look at the overspeed he's got on the run down towards turn one there. But now we need 2 retirements in this Grand Prix there. Yeah, Perez, actually, that's where he was. Perez was obviously the man that had those issues earlier on in the Grand Prix there. So it wasn't a mechanical failure. It was just a mechanical issue for the Mexican there. And he fought his way back through the field over those next couple of laps there. But you can see, unfortunately for myself, as I come to realization about where Sergio Perez was, yeah, he'd gone in this Grand Prix there. There was nothing we could really do to try and defend from the Williams car there. And weirdly enough, behind us, the gap has started to open up once again there. Albon now will find himself in a bit of no man's land as well as we head on to the final lap of the Grand Prix. It's going to be Pierre Gasly coming through to win the race there. Not often have we seen the Frenchman take home race victories there, but I'm sure he's happy to finally get the upper hand over his teammate Max Verstappen. Down in towards the final couple of corners we go of the race there. I think, to be fair, we got everything we could out of the car today there, but it's only P12 in the end. Boy, oh boy, do we need these Season 4 regulations to work in our favour.
All right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Red Bull pulling out all the stops today. What a great win. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
It was a question of right place, right time today. We were looking at an entirely different race before the safety car came out, but they were able to take full advantage after the field had been bunched up.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everyone at the team. So, let's review the driver's standings. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
That's got to be the Flying Finn. Wait, how many Flying Finns have we had now? Anyway, I'm talking about Bottas this time. Just great raw speed, and a good job in traffic as well.
Let's move on to the constructors. Red Bull pull further ahead in the standings. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for the next one.
So there we are then, guys, the end of the Japanese Grand Prix there. Pierre Gasly, race win and fastest lap, the full 26 points on the board, as well as a pole position there. A 10-second race victory over Sebastian Vettel, who does take a small chunk out of championship leader there, Max Verstappen. Hamilton in fourth, Hülkenberg, Leclerc, Norris, Bottas, Sainz, Stroll, Perez, myself, Albon, Grosjean, Kvyat, Butler, Raikkonen, Giovinazzi, and Daniel Ricciardo actually a lap down at the end of the day. Not too sure what happened to him in the dying stages of that race there. But like I said, Verstappen, he loses out a few points to Sebastian Vettel, but it is still looking like he is in very good shape to take home the World Championship this year out. The gap at the top now, just back down to 24 points. Sebastian Vettel, if next weekend's Mexican Grand Prix was the finale, he would still just about be within a shot there. Gasly up in P3 still. The only actual swap would be Lando Norris, unfortunately, jumping back up ahead of myself as the battle of the second best British there. Back up into P9 for him. Just behind the Ferraris, the Renaults, the Racing Points, and the Red Bulls there. And in the constructors, still looking pretty safe for P6 at the end of the day as well there. But thank you all so much for watching this video. Do get yourself subscribed if you're new around here as well, and you do want to see more of the F1 2019 Haas Road to Glory. We will be back next time out for the Mexican Grand Prix.